we are dealing with matrices now, matrix algebra. So matrices is like a regular arrangement of some elements. Matrix is about regular arrangement of elements. So that's what the matrices is. You are able to see the textbook.
Yeah.
I hope so. And now,
yeah.
So here you come in. So they will give some examples. Don't worry too much about the examples. It's like a regular arrangement of the things. I mean, in numbers or some elements, or it can be A, B, C, D, whatever it is, we will put it in rows and columns. So what is a row and what is a column? I'll let you know. So here we go. So yeah. This is what the horizontal thing is called a row.
Yeah.
The vertical thing is called a column. Okay. Vertical thing is called a column. So how many rows are there? 1, 2, 3. Three rows and two columns are there. So the matrix is 3 by 2. Rows into columns. So it is 3 by 2. We'll read it as 3 by 2. This is called order of matrix. Order of matrix. Very simple. This is called order of the matrix. So here you see. So here you, I don't know, this letters are coming in a different way. I don't know why it is printed that way. Not sure of that. So here we go down further. So here you go. There are some examples. Matrix is M by N is written as like this. M by N refers to M rows and M columns. Very simple.
Okay.
So that is how it is. So once we take up the problems, you will understand. Okay. So here you go. You have to find the order of each matrix. Okay. So you have 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. We'll start doing. So the first matrix is like this. We'll write 2, 3, 4, 5. You have to find the order of the matrix. So two rows and two columns. So you can see that. So that order is 2 by 2. Very simple. Now you see this 2, 3, 7. So let's check 2, 3, 7. It's like this. Actually, the comma will not be given. Sometimes they'll give comma. The comma will not be given. So it is only one row and three columns.
And three columns.
1 by 3. So that's what it is. And now, you see this one? So, here, if I write like this, 2, 3, 7. Suppose 2, 3, 7. Like this, if I write, there are 3 rows and 1 column. And so, that is 3 by 1. So, suppose the next one. Next one is 1, 2, 3. And you have some 4, 8, 10. Some 4, 8, 10.
One,
so it's what you have is two rows, three columns. So as simple as it. So we have, these are the things. Hope you are clear. And now find the following matrix. Find the order of A. So how many rows are there? Three rows are there. So 3 rows. How many columns? 4 columns are there.
Four.
So it's 3 by 4. Finished. Now, this is very easy. I tell you, compared to the first book, your second book is much easier.
Really? Okay.
Really, it is easy. Yeah. Only thing is, you little bit of effort you have to put. That's it.
And but this is 80 marks.
Yeah. Little bit of more effort you have to put. That's it. This is really, really easy. I tell you, starting, you see matrices, very, very easy matrices. Easily you can score marks. The first book is little bit tough, I tell you. The second book is very, very easy. It goes really smooth, I tell you. The only thing is, you have to be like sure with the formulas. If you are through with the formulas, you are done with this book.
Okay.
90% of the problems straight, you apply the formula, you will get the answer. It is like that.
Okay.
Now, write the total number of elements of A. How many? See, This will give the total number of elements. 3 times 4. Right? Mm-hmm. Right. 12 elements you will be there. You just check. 4 plus 4 plus 4. 12. Right?
Yeah.
So that is where 12. Okay. Total elements of A is 12. 3 by 4. That will tell that. Okay. Write the elements. A to 3. This one I will tell you. So this one to do that. See. For that I will share the board with you. So for that I will tell you. See. Elements to know the elements. I will tell you.
Yeah.
See, A, we will represent the elements as Aij. Okay. Is the row number and J is column number.
Okay.
I is the row number and J is the column number. This is Aij. And now, A, first to start with, this is in the first row and first column. A11, this is how we write. Next. This is in the first row, second column. So, A12. Similarly. First row, third column, A13. First row, fourth column, A14. Got it?
Okay.
Now, this one will be A2, second row, first column. Second row, second column, A22.
Oh.
Second row, third column, A23.
A22.
Second row, fourth column. Got
it? A23.
A24.
Okay, yeah.
Right. Now, next element, this one will be, how do we designate? How do we designate this element?
A31.
A31, that's it. This one will be A32. This one?
A33.
This one is?
A34.
And now this one will be, can you tell?
A41.
Very good. This one will be?
A42.
A42.
A43 and A44.
Very good. That's it. That's it. As simple as that. So this is how the elements are designated in the matrix. Simple?
Okay, yeah.
Simple. Now, let's go back to the textbook ones. So here, they asked what are the values of A23. Means that second row, third column.
Mm. So second row,
third
A23.
Second row, third column. Second row, third column. So A23 is 2. Got it?
Okay.
Okay. Now, A32. Can you guess and tell me what is A32?
A32 is third row, second column.
Yeah. So it will be 2. Very good. Now, A14 they asked. What is A14?
First row, fourth column.
Very good. Next one is A34. Yeah. Tell me what is A34? A34 is 6.
6.
That's the answers. Got it? Easy?
Yeah. Yeah.
So express each element 3 in each element 3 in A in the form of Aij. Okay. Wherever 3 is coming, they asked wherever 3 is coming, you had to represent in the form of Aij. So, wherever 3 is coming, 3 is coming here.
A22. So
this is A22, that is 3. And where else 3 is coming?
A31, sorry.
This is A31, that is also 3. Where else 3 is
A33.
Coming? A33, very good. A33, you got again 3. That's it. That's all the answers are. Clear?
Yeah.
That's the answers. Fine. Now let's move on. So here itself we have solved. So we solve this. If the element of ith row and jth column of a 2x3 matrix A is given up. This is a very, very important question.
Okay.
So, the first thing is that we have to write the information of this. Given matrix first. Given matrix is 2x3. Or the 2x3 matrix. So how to write a 2x3 matrix? First write that. That means it contains two rows and three columns. Got it? No. Two rows and three columns. 2x3 means two rows and three columns, right? So write the first row. It will be A11, A12, A13. And the second row will be A21, A22, A23. Got it? Arti, did you get this? Hello?
It muted. Yes.
Oh, yeah, you got it, no? How to write that?
Yes.
Okay, fine. And now they have given us Aij. Aij will be. So they have given some formula for Aij. What is that formula? I plus 2j by 2.
I plus
2j by 2. So we'll note it. This is given by I plus 2j by 2. And now the question is, you had to construct the matrix. Question will be normally construct the matrix. Okay. Write the matrix A or construct the matrix. Okay. Write the matrix A or construct the matrix.
Matrix,
the question
okay.
is of this form. Write the matrix. Write the matrix A. Matrix A or construct the matrix. So how do we deal with this? Now, here you have written all the elements. So A11, each position element you have to see. A11. That means I value is 1, J value is 1. Plug in that in the formula.
Okay.
So, I value 1 plus 2 divided by 2. So, it is 3/2. Right?
Yeah.
First part is over. So, similarly, A12. Can we calculate A12?
So it's 1 plus 2 into 2.
Right? 2 into 2 divided by 2. So, it is 5/2. So similarly, A13.
One plus two into three
divided by 2. So it is 7/2. So similarly, you have A21.
Two plus two into one.
Very good. Divided by two. So 2 plus 2. That is 4. 4/2 is 2. Right. So A22.
A22 is 2 plus 2 into 2.
So what we got? 6. Right? 6/2.
Yeah.
That is 3. Next. Next what we have?
Next it is A23. So
that is
1,
2 plus 2 into 3. 6.
2 into 3.
2. So that is 8/2. That is 4. Clear? So, can we construct the matrix A now? Find all the elements like this. You have to construct the matrix A. So, what is A11? 3/2. Next, A12 is 5/2.
5/2.
Next, A13 is 7/2.
7/2.
Next, A21 is 2.
2.
A22 is 3. A23 is 4. That's it. Finished. Hence the answer.
Yeah.
That's the required answer. Clear? No.
Yeah.
So this is very easy. Very easily one can solve. So let's see the next question. Now, we have the next question. What is the next question? there are two stores A and B. In store A, there are 120 shirts and 100 trousers and 50 cardigans. What is this?
Cardigans.
I don't know what is that. And store B has 200 shirts, 150 trousers and 100 cardigans. Express this information in tabular form in different ways and also in the matrix form. This you can do. This is not an issue. See, shirts, store A and store B, like this, you can form a 2x3 or a 3x2 matrix. Okay, this is not a very, very that much thing. But it's like a basic funda of understanding matrices. They asked you to represent this in the matrix form. So this is the matrix. Shirts, store A, store B, 120, 200, 150. So that I think this cardigans is like a banyan, I think. So that is 50, 100. They you just have to put it in the matrix form. So how do we put that in matrix form? You see here, 120, 150, like this. 120, 150. This is one way. The next one is 200, 150, 100. 200. 150, 100. You had to read the information and just write it. So this is very easy. Now, you can invert it and write also. So they have written like story A and store B, shirts, trousers and cardigans. So, so you can invert it and write. How do you write this? 120,
120,
100, 150, like this. This row you invert into column. And now this row you invert into column. This is like 200, 150, 100. This is called transpose. If you exchange the rows and columns, what you get is called transpose.
Okay.
This is called A. This is called A transpose. Actually, transpose means you exchange with the rows and columns. You flip-flop the rows and columns. That's what is called a transpose of the matrix. That's what they want to demonstrate to you here. So that's the funda. And now let's see the exercise, what we will get the exercise. So check your progress, 20.1. We'll see the exercise here. So marks scored by students A and B in three tests are given in the adjacent table. Represent the information in the matrix form in two ways. They ask like this. So the first one, easily we can do. The first one is the matrix A will write 56, 65, 71. First write as
56,
65, 71. And now you have 29, 37, 57.
29, 37, 57.
And then you take the A transpose. That means you exchange the rows and columns. You flip it.
Yeah.
So 56, 29, you write 56, 29 like this as a row, 65, 37 29. As another row, 65, 37 as another row, 71, 57 as another row, 71, 57 as another row. So that's it, done deal. These are the two ways you can express the same information. So this is called transpose of the matrix.
Okay.
Clear? Now let's move on. Now let's move on. So here we go. The next question is
2 or 3 firms.
There are three firms XYZ supply 40, 35, and 25 truckloads of stones and 10, 5, 8 truckloads of sand respectively to a contractor. Okay. Express the information in the form of matrix in two ways. Okay.
Stones.
So this is for the construction type. So X, Y, Z are there. You have stones.
But, yeah.
And then you have sand. Okay. So this is the construction work related type of question. This is 40, 35,
25.
40, 35, 25. You have to form the table. And the next one is the sand 10, 5, 8.
10,
5, 8. So let's represent this as a matrix. The first one is the 40, 35, 25. 40, 35, 25. And now 10, 5, 8 is the other thing. So when you take the A transpose, how the A transpose will be? So that I will tell you. This is the first part. This is the first part. Out of this, this is the matrix. Right?
Yeah.
Now the other part is, we'll write stones and sand. And we'll write X, Y, Z here. Okay? The stones will be like 40, 35, 25. 40, 35, 25.
40. Same way which they gave us.
Yeah, same way. 10, 5, 8. 10, 5, 8. So here you go. The matrix, this one will be A transpose. The A transpose is 40, 35, 25, and then 10, 5, 8. 10, 5, 8.
5, 8.
So that is my A transpose. Clear?
Yeah.
Yeah. Let's clear this off. Next one. In a family P, are four men and six women and three children. And family Q. So the family P and family Q will write it. So men,
four,
woman and children. So men will be then 4, 6, 3. Okay, 4,
yeah,
6, 3.
Three.
And the woman in the family queue there, men 4, 3, 5. Right. 4, 3, 5. So the matrix express form is expressed in the form of matrix. 4, 6, 3 in and 4, 3, 5.
Yeah.
This is the matrix. And the transpose you can do. You can try the transpose. The transpose part is simply you got to invert the rows and columns. So this
is two rows.
Yeah, yeah, that's it. 6, 3.
And three columns.
3, 5. Right.
Yeah.
So this is a 2 by 3. This is 3 by 2. Okay.
Yeah.
Rows are the horizontal things.
This is two into three.
Yeah, the first one is 2 by 3. The second one is 3 by 2.
First one is row and second one is column.
Yeah. Horizontal are rows. Second, vertical things are columns. Horizontal things are rows. So, 2 rows are there. 3 columns.
Yeah.
Clear? Okay. Now, let's move on.
But in the other one, it's 3 into 2.
This is 2 by 3 matrix they asked. The other one is 3 by 2. 2 by 3 they asked. So 2 by 3 is the first matrix what we have written. So it is 4, 6, 3 straight. That is 4, 6, 3. And 4, 3, 5 is the required answer. This is our 2 by 3 matrix.
Yeah.
This is our required 2 by 3 matrix. Clear? Now.
Yeah.
How many elements are there in a 2 by 3 matrix? 2, 3, 6. That's it.
6.
3, 4 is 12.
12.
4 to 8.
8.
12. 9 to 18. AB. MN. That's it. Straight. The answers are straight. So that is how one can solve the problem. That's a specific pick. This specific quickly we have solved this exercise. Now, what are the possible orders of matrix if it has 8 elements? So, this is very tricky question. Somewhat tricky, not very tough.
Eight elements.
So, possible orders we have to find. 8 elements are there. What are the possible orders?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. It can either be 2 into 3.
No. 8 elements you have to get. So first is 1
3 into
3.
Eight.
Wait. Oh, 3 into 3. 1 into
9.
8.
Oh, yeah.
1 into 8. Or 8 into 1.
Or 4 into 2.
Yeah. Now you are understanding. It can be 4 into 2 or
2 into 4.
2 by 4. Anything else possible?
No.
Anything else? Think a little bit more.
It can be.
Yeah.
No, it can't.
Yeah, you are right. So only 4 possible. These are the 4 possibles. Got it?
Oh, okay. I thought you have to write down like 1, 2, 3.
And make the box. You don't have to. You don't have to. 8 elements you have to get. You just check the products where you 8 you will get. Okay. Where 8 you will get.
Okay.
So in the matrix, you don't have like so I fill some 2 elements, 2, 3 here and 7 here and leave this space blank. We don't do that. Okay. For matrices, I can leave one space blank like this. We cannot do. Okay. Got it? You cannot leave spaces blank in a matrix. Okay. So this confusion is gone, I hope. Now, 5 elements.
5 into 1 and 1 into 5.
That's it. 5 into 1 or 1 into 5. 1 by 5. Okay. These are the possible orders. So these are the 2 orders you can express. Now, 12 elements.
12 into 1 and 1 into 12 and 6 into 2.
Yeah. 6 and, into 2.
And 2 into 2 by 6.
6. Next.
16 into 1.
Sorry.
And 1 into 6. 16 into 1 and 1 into 16.
16 now.
Yeah, 16 elements.
No, no. 12 you have not completed yet. Think.
3 into 2. 3 into. No, wait. 3 into 4.
Yeah, you forgot it. 3 into 4 are 4 by 3.
Four
so, how
three.
Many total? 6.
1,
right?
2, 3, 4. Yeah.
6 possible orders. Clear?
Mm-hmm.
Now, 16. Now you try 16.
16 into 1 and 1 into 16.
16 by 1. We'll call it 16 by 1 or 1 16 by 16.
By, 1 by 16. And 4, 4 by 4.
Next is?
4 by 4.
4 by 4. There is only one pass. One another possibility. Anything else? Anything else?
Oh yeah, 8 into 2.
Yeah. 8 into 2 or?
2 into
2 8. 2 into 8, right? So how many in total? Anything else is there? Anything else? Check it.
No, I don't.
Yeah,
no.
You don't have any other thing. So, 5 possibilities. Okay, clear?
Yeah.
So, these are 5 possible ways. Total is 5 possible ways. 5 possible orders. Okay. So, how many ways you can arrange the 16 elements? These are the ways. That's what it is. Let's see. In the matrix A, some matrix they have given. It is not here. I don't know why. I don't know why it is like this. The number of columns. Find the number of rows. How many rows are there? So,
1, 2, 3, 4
rows are there. Number of rows
and
are
4.
Now, how many columns? 1,
4,
2, 3, 4, 5 columns are there.
5?
5.
2,
yeah,
3, 4.
1. 2, 3, 4, 5 columns. Okay. 4 rows and 5 columns. Clear? So, 5 columns. The order of matrix A is 4 by 5. Got it? Now, the total number of elements of A, 4, 5 is 20.
20.
Okay. So, A14, A23, they asked me to find. Okay, you can do that.
0.
Why?
A14. first row. Fourth column.
Okay. Yeah, that is zero. Okay, that you can do. If the matrix is not clear to us, that I hope you can do. That is not an issue. Yes. Now you can do this. Right, fine. Construct a 3x3 matrix whose elements of ith row and jth column are given by this. And now we will start solving. We had to construct a 3x3 matrix. Construct a 3x3 matrix. So once they tell you to do that, what we will do is first try to write the 3x3 matrix in the Aij form. So it is A11, A12, A13. So three rows should be there and three columns, okay? So A21, A22, A23. And A31, A32, A33. We'll write this. And now they have given the formula of Aij as I minus j, the first one. So let's plug in that. So first let's find each element. A11, I is equal to 1, j is equal to 1. That is 1 minus 1, 0, right? And now A12, that is 1 minus 2, right? Minus 1. A13, that is 1 minus 3, that is minus 2. Clear?
Yeah.
Now, A21, that is 2 minus 1, that is 1. Yeah. A22, that is 2 minus 2, 0,
minus
right?
0, yeah.
Next, A23, can you calculate this?
A23 is 2 minus 3, minus 1.
Minus 1, very good. Now, we'll calculate A31. A31 is 3 minus A3, 1, that
3
is?
Minus 1.
That is
2. 1. 2, sorry.
A32, that is 3 minus 2.
Minus 2, 1.
1. And A33 is 3 minus 0. 3. That is 0. Now we have to plug in these things in the respective positions. Respective positions. That's most important. Values you have to plug in the respective positions. So A11, that is 0. A12, we got it as minus 1. A13, we got it as minus 2. Okay. Now, A21, we got it as 1. Now, A22, we got it as 0 and minus 1. Okay. Now, A31, we got it as 2. A32, we got it as 1. And A33, we got it as 0. Clear? First one? Okay. Now, we'll keep this matrix as it is.
Okay.
And then solve for the next one, Aij. Aij, they have given the next formula. Then we have to solve for that. So let us see the next formula. So what is the next formula? We'll see. So Aij is i² / j. So let's
okay.
Very funny things they have given. Aij is i² divided by j. That is Aij. So i² So let's calculate 1 by 1. So A11. That is 1² by 1. So that is 1.
One.
Now, A12 is 1 square by 2. That is
1 half. By 2.
A13 is 1 square by 3. That is 1 by 3. Fine. Yeah. Now, A21.
2 square by 1.
That is 4.
4.
A22. That is 2² by 2. That is 2.
4 by 2.
A23, that is again 2² / 3.
4 by 3.
Now, A31, we have to solve. A13, we already solved. A31, that is 3 square by 1. That is 9.
9.
A32, right?
9 by 2.
That is 9 by 2. And A33, that is 3 square by 3. That is 3. So let's plug in that elements at the respective positions. So A11, that is 1. A12, that is half.
Half.
A13, that is 1 by 3.
By 2.
Okay. What the
four.
First row?
A21.
That is 4 by 3.
4 by 3.
Next one is
9 by 2, 3.
So we have put up in the respective positions, that's the required matrix.
Answer.
So that is the required 3 by 3 matrix. Okay. Now let's move on. So can you solve the rest?
Yeah.
So that you can do it as homework.
Okay.
You can do this as homework with the rest. So I mark this. These two,
yeah.
You can try it as homework.
Okay. I plus 2j
whole square divided by 2. You just have to plug in the numbers.
Plug in the values.
And then you after finding the values, you have to put those things at the respective positions. That's most important. If you miss the position, okay. Your matrix is wrong.
Okay.
That's how we have to deal with it. Okay, now let's move on. Now, construct a 3 by 2 matrix whose elements are in the ith row and jth column given by this. Also, the same type of stuff. Same yeah. type of stuff. So this also you can take it as homework. This one also. So the 7th and 8th.
Okay.
Take it as homework. And then solve this. So this is very, very easy. Practice from now on. It's very, very, it becomes very, very easy.
Yeah.
And now let us see some definitions now. They are having some definitions. Something called a row matrix. And a column matrix is what they are going to talk. See, a row matrix is something where there will be only one row.
Okay.
That's what is a row matrix. So it is of the order 1 by n. It can have any number of columns, yeah. Doesn't matter. So, but it will have only one row.
One row.
That is called a row matrix. So the column matrix, if you see, you have only one column.
One column.
Of the order m by 1. Now, the other thing is called a square matrix. Square matrix is the one where you have the rows, number of rows is equal to number of columns. That is a square matrix.
Number so of
rows is equal to number of columns. Okay.
Okay.
So it's like number of rows is equal to number of columns.
Yeah.
That's called a square matrix.
Okay.
Square matrix. Value. What is the square matrix? The number of rows is equal to number of columns. Then you will say that it's a square matrix. Clear?
Okay. Yeah.
Okay. Now, so the order of the matrix will be of the form n by n, m by m, or n by n type. So earlier we solved a 3 by 3 matrix, right? 3 by 3 matrix. Yeah. We just solved right now. That's a square matrix. Because the number of rows is equal to number of columns.
Number of columns.
Okay. So such a matrix is called a square matrix. Okay. The diagonal of the square matrix from the top extreme left element to the bottom extreme right element is said to be principal diagonal, the principal diagonal of the matrix. Okay. I will tell you about the principal diagonal. This is another important thing in the matrices. So that we will see. What I tell you is that, suppose let me take a 3 by 3 matrix, for example. So normally we deal with the 3 by 3 matrix. Let us say 2, 1, 7, 3, 5, 11, 6, 2, 3. OK? Okay, we have written a 3x3 matrix now.
Yeah.
In the 3x3 matrix, you take this one.
2, 5, 3.
Yeah, that is the diagonal. Okay. Topmost left to rightmost bottom. Okay.
Yeah.
So this is called diagonal, principal diagonal.
Okay.
So this makes lot of calculations. Very, very important calculations are done through this principal diagonal. Okay. In the matrix algebra. Okay. So in the principal diagonal, what are the elements in the principal diagonal? That is 2, 5, 3.
2, 5, 3.
These are the elements in the principal diagonal in this. Elements of
principal
diagonal. Okay, PD, we'll write in short form. Okay.
Yeah.
So that's very easy. So that's how we designate the principal diagonal. So for any square matrix, the principal diagonal exists.
Okay.
For any square matrix, the principal diagonal exists. So let's see the next part. A rectangular matrix, any matrix of order like 2x3, m is not equal to n. So okay. If the situation is like m not equal to n, m is not equal to n, such a thing is called a rectangular matrix. So
okay.
They need not specify that rectangular matrix, but so all the things, okay, it's called rectangular matrix.
Rectangular matrix.
So 1x n or Coram matrix, row matrix, they are all rectangular matrices. Okay. Zero or null matrix. What is a null matrix? Null matrix.
Then everything is zero.
Every element is zero.
Zero.
Such a thing is called null matrix.
Okay.
Null matrix.
Matrix.
Where every element is zero.
Zero.
Such a thing is called null matrix.
Null matrix.
Null matrix or zero matrix, they can be of any order. Okay. They can represent that in of any order.
Okay.
So here we go. Diagonal matrix. A square matrix is said to be diagonal matrix if the elements other than those occurring in the principal diagonal are zero. So I will give you the example of this one. What is a diagonal matrix? So 2, 0, 0. 0, 5, 0. 0, 0, 3. This is a diagonal matrix. Why? You see the principal diagonal.
2, 5, 3.
2, 5, 3. Except this, every other element is 0.
Oh, that is diagonal matrix.
That's called a diagonal matrix.
Okay.
Clear? So this happens on a square matrix only.
Okay, when everything is 0 except diagonal.
Except the diagonal. Except the principal diagonal. Not just one diagonal.
This is also taken as diagonal.
But this is the diagonal we are talking about. Except the principal diagonal, each and every element is 0. That is called a diagonal matrix.
Yeah.
So that is what a diagonal matrix is. So let's see the next part. So here we go. They have given some examples.
Scalar matrix.
Next one is a scalar matrix. Okay. A diagonal matrix is said to be scalar matrix if all the elements in it, principal diagonal, equal to some non-zero constant, that is K, and the matrix is called a scalar matrix. Now, this is also a diagonal matrix, but there is a little bit of difference between them. What is the difference? 3, 0, 0, 0, 3, 0, 0, 0, 3. You see this? It has same element repeating all over the diagonal.
Then it is called a scalar matrix.
It is called a scalar matrix if all the elements are equal. in the diagonal.
Yeah. Okay.
That they are writing in different way. Something, something that you can say that all elements are equal in the diagonal.
Yeah, okay.
So that equality is some constant k. It can be like k 0, 0. 0, k, 0. 0, yeah. 0, k. If any matrix is of this form, it is called a scalar matrix.
Scalar matrix.
It is called a scalar matrix. It's called a scalar matrix. Clear?
Yeah. We'll
clear this off. No, that's a scalar matrix. Unit or identity matrix. This is another thing. What is an identity matrix? Instead of any other constant, if 1 is there, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1. This is called identity matrix of order 3 by 3. It is having lot of properties. I, we will call it, I is given by 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1. So this is called an identity matrix of order 3 by 3. Clear the thing?
Yeah.
We'll go ahead. Next, unit matrix or identity matrix we have covered. So let's move on.
Equal matrix.
Equal matrices. So when two matrix are equal, when you can equate two matrices.
Okay.
Remember this. If matrices of same order can only be equated.
Okay.
Can only be equated. I cannot equate. You cannot equate a 3 by 2 matrix with a 2 by 3 matrix because the positions of the element should match. So if I had to equate a 3 by 2 matrix with a 3 by 2 matrix. Okay.
Okay.
If I equate two matrices, the corresponding elements are equal. Corresponding elements are equal. It's so easy. Elements are equal. So that is the important funda which you have to grasp. So if I'm equating two matrices of the same order, the corresponding elements, the corresponding position, the elements which are in the corresponding positions, they're all equal.
Equal.
So let us say one small problem kind of thing. It's not even a problem. You see this X, Y, Z, W. Suppose if I give you like this is equal to minus 1, 1, 2, 1. Suppose I give you like this. Okay, 2 minus 1. Let us give like this. So what are the values of X, Y, Z? So corresponding position you just equate. X corresponding
one.
X is minus 1.
Minus 1.
Y is 1.
Z is
that
2.
Is 2. And W is minus 1.
That's minus it. 1. Okay.
As simple as it. So that corresponding. So here why I could equate is because this is a 2 by 2 matrix. This is also 2 by 2 matrix. That's why I'm able to equate.
Equate. Okay.
Because the corresponding elements I had to equate. For that I need to have the matrices of the same order. Then only I can equate the matrices.
Okay. Vima? Yeah.
So let's see the next part of the thing. So the corresponding elements, so we have equated. Find whether the following matrices are equal or not. It's very simple. You just check the corresponding elements, they are not equal.
No.
And the next one, you can see that they are these two matrices are of same order, but the corresponding elements, they are not equal. So they are not equal. Now these two matrices are of different order altogether. Yeah. So you cannot equate these two.
The third one is right.
Third one, the corresponding elements are equal. You see this, corresponding elements are equal. So So it's they are equal matrices. Clear?
Yeah.
As simple as that. So that's how one can equate the matrices. So this is easy. Compared to definitely this is easy.
Yeah.
I tell you, this is very easy actually. Determine the variables x and y if they have given you like this. So looking at it itself, you can tell. X equal to 2, corresponding element. X equal to 2. Done.
And 5 is 5.
X is equal to 4. Y is equal to 3. Y is equal to 3. X is equal to 4. Job done. Now, here X is equal to 1. Okay. Minus Y is equal to 5. So, Y is minus 5. Okay. Y is minus Y equal to 5. No.
Yeah.
Minus y is equal to 5. Y should be five.
Minus 5.
So that's how we can equate the matrices.
Okay.
Okay. Now, after this, I hope this is where we will stop, Amma. So tomorrow we'll continue with the rest and whatever.
Tomorrow, actually, I'm not sure because I have tennis till.
Okay. Tomorrow we'll take a break.
Clock to 4:30, 4:30 to 5:30.
Tomorrow, your friend is coming tomorrow, Sneha. So,
did she send you the question, the worksheet?
Yeah, she has sent me. She has sent me the
worksheet. Is it very different this year? Like,
I'm not sure. She has sent me some worksheets. So I will discuss physics with her tomorrow. So at the same time, I will fix with her 8:30. So no issues. So we'll meet day after tomorrow then.
Yeah.
Okay, ma.
Okay, bye-bye. Good night.
Good night. Take care. Bye.